Welcome back to family, welcome back to my channel. So today for you guys, I have a floral wedding centerpiece DIY to share with you, showing you how to create centerpieces using real flowers that you can use for your wedding, and they're gonna last up until your event. Usually you wanna do like a couple of days before your event, but you do want to have it where there's a continuous water source so the flowers don't die on you. So I'm gonna share with you guys how I did this centerpiece. I actually helped my cousin do my sister's centerpieces and bouquets for her wedding. My cousin did mine for my wedding. I chose the flowers, but she did it for me. So I'm gonna share with you guys what I know about doing centerpieces. If you want more advice, I recommend looking at other YouTube videos. This is how we did my sister's centerpieces, and we started on her centerpieces a couple of days before her wedding. You don't want to start too soon, because obviously the flowers are gonna die on you if you start too soon. Yesterday I uploaded a video all about my wedding decor, and the reason I uploaded that one yesterday and this day is because I have been getting so many questions recently about my decor and the flowers that I used and how I did the flowers. And I think that's because right now it's like engagement season and people are planning for their weddings that are coming up, and then there's also like baby showers and graduation parties that are all coming up. So this is a really affordable way to do flowers yourself. If you don't want to do the flowers, get some friends and family to help you out. That's what I had when it came to my own wedding. When it comes to weddings and flowers, oh my gosh, it's so expensive. So if you're gonna go with a florist and you're trying to cut down on like price, I recommend going with a lot of greenery or fillers versus a lot of flowers. That way you can save some type of money, because greenery is cheaper than getting like actual flowers. It's really expensive. So if you have the help to kind of do it yourself, I recommend doing it yourself. I really hope this video is helpful for some of you guys. If you like the video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. Let's begin the tutorial. Ooh, my allergies. So when it came to my sister's wedding flowers and my wedding flowers, we bought them in bulk. So Costco and Sam's Club carry flowers in bulk, and it's the cheapest you're gonna get them in bulk. There was only one of the flowers in my bouquets and centerpieces that I didn't get from Sam's Club, and I got them from 50 Flowers. Now 50 Flowers is more expensive than Sam's Club and Costco. I just wanted a dusty rose color that I couldn't find on either website. If you're buying your flowers in bulk, there's a process to it. You wanna order the flowers 5 to 6 days before the wedding. Once you get them, you gotta put them in water and let them blossom. Takes about 24 hours or at least overnight to do. Then you start working on the centerpieces, because the centerpieces tend to have a water source. Then the day before the wedding, you want to work on like the bouquets and corsages, because they don't have a water source. You can put the bouquets overnight in water, but like the corsages, you got to spray them with water. They have a very short lifespan. So for this tutorial, I'm going to be using some bunches of flowers I got at my local supermarket. They're 3 for $12 there. It's called Jewel Osco in my area. I know around the United States, they can also be called Albertsons. They carry bunches of flowers 3 for $12, and it's actually cheaper to buy them like this versus Sam's Club and Costco, which are pretty cheap to begin with, or go to Trader Joe's, which has inexpensive flowers. But the problem with that is they might not have the flowers you want the day that you go. But if you aren't really picky with the flowers you're getting, or you just want like baby's breath everything, I highly recommend going to your local grocery store, because it's cheaper to do it that way. For this bouquet, I got baby's breath, these Callen Co bunches. I got Israeli Ruscus, which my sister and I both had at our weddings, and it's really inexpensive, especially when you're buying it in bulk. I got this purple Santini palms, which I think I also had at my wedding. I can't remember exactly. I had a eucalyptus mix, which for sure I had at my wedding. And then I got these small little like rose pieces. They're just like rose bunches, but they're on the smaller side. If you're trying to save money, I recommend going with more greenery versus flowers and things like baby's breath. Those are inexpensive, and that's stuff I used. So if you're using real flowers, you're going to need wet foam. This is foam that can be wet and it absorbs the water. If you're using fake flowers, you can use dry foam. For my centerpieces and my sister's centerpieces, we used these bowls that are from Dollar Tree. They come 4 or 6 in a pack. I can't remember exactly. So what we did is we took our foam and we cut it down to fit the inside of those bowls. So you're gonna have to cut a piece off, shove it inside of the bowl, and then cut off any excess foam. The foam I'm using came in a 4-pack that I got at Hobby Lobby. It was actually cheaper to do it that way versus going to Dollar Tree, and the foam was just way better than the wet foam that Dollar Tree carries. But if you want to go to Dollar Tree, you can go ahead and do that.
So once I have my piece of wet foam cut out, you want to leave a little bit left at the top because you're going to be using this to stick all your flowers inside of. So you want it to be popping out of the bowl a little bit. But once I have that all cut down, I get a bowl of water. If you're doing a bunch of centerpieces, I was only doing one here. You want to get like buckets of water, and you're going to be placing the foam inside of the water, and you're going to wait for the foam to absorb that water and just kind of sink to the bottom. Once it sinks to the bottom, you know there's enough water. You don't want to overdo it. You don't want it to soak too much, but you want to make sure there's water throughout the entire thing. And this is going to be the water source for your flowers so that they stay alive till your event date. We started working on my sister's centerpieces 3 days before her wedding. We were getting the greenery, like the leaves off of the roses. And then the next day we were working on the centerpieces, and the day before the wedding, the bouquets and the corsages. So once you got your floral foam wet, you can then place it inside of whatever it is that you're using. So I'm using these bowls because I have these gold stands they can be placed on, or this little glass stand that I made using Dollar Tree products. I'll link it down below for you guys. Next up, you're going to take floral tape and you are going to tape the foam to your bowl. At first, I was using some Dollar Tree floral tape. It was terrible. Save the money, go elsewhere and get better tape. Floral tape doesn't feel sticky at first, but it's when you stretch it that it really gets sticky. You need to tape the foam in place so that it's not falling out and your centerpiece and the foam is just rolling all over the car when you're trying to transport it, or even when you're placing it on a stand. You don't want that foam to come out of the bowl. Now, when it comes to your flowers, you want to remove any of the leaves that are on them off of them, or if there's thorns, you got to remove the thorns. Usually you'll use gloves or something if there's thorns. The reason you want to remove all of the leaves is so that the flowers stay alive longer. What I read and what I heard is that the leaves kill the flower faster, so you just want to remove them. And it just looks better. It doesn't look that good to have all these leaves inside of the centerpiece. But hey, if that's your style, that's your style. You could go ahead and do that. But I heard that it kills the flowers faster if you leave the leaves on them. Some of the flowers you're using might have a delicate stem, so they won't be able to stand up straight on their own inside of your centerpiece. So that's where floral wire comes in handy. So if you have any flowers where the stem is kind of delicate, these flowers, the stem wasn't really delicate. You'll be able to tell, but to show you guys what I'm talking about, I'm using these flowers as an example. So what you'll do is you'll take your wire and you'll put it through the center of the stem. Be careful. And then you just kind of wrap that wire around the stem. So this gives it a nice base so that the flower can stand up straight on its own. Like I said, these flowers in particular I was using, the stem wasn't weak or delicate, nothing like that. It was able to stand on its own, but I went ahead and did it this way so you guys could see what you're actually supposed to do. None of the flowers I used had a delicate stem. They were all able to stand up straight on their own. But I know when it came to my sister's bouquet, there was this one flower we used. I can't remember what the name was, but it was a very delicate stem. So if you try to hold one of the flowers by the stem, it would just start drooping down on you. So we had to put the wires through them so that it wouldn't droop down. It's up to you how you want to work your centerpiece. You can start off with one flower at a time, which I recommend doing one flower at a time. You could start with the greenery if you want to. For me, it was best to do the flowers first and then add the greenery, because once I had the flowers, the amount of flowers I wanted in the centerpiece, then I just used the greenery to fill up the gaps that I had. And basically I had enough flowers to do two centerpieces and full centerpieces. And I just, I went by eye. So when we did my sister's, it was just very uniform. So there was one flower on each side and then one flower at the top. When it came to this bouquet, I had flowers everywhere. I personally like the look of flowers just like everywhere, but that's up to you. And if you're doing it like one flower on one side, on the other side, so on and so forth, you cut down on how many flowers that you need. But if you're getting inexpensive flowers, you could probably afford to get more than just a few. You know what I'm trying to say? So like these flowers, they were inexpensive, so I was able to get a bunch of bunches of flowers, so I had enough flowers to add everywhere around my centerpieces, versus if I was just getting roses, I wouldn't have enough to put everywhere that I want to. I don't know if that makes sense, but hey, when you're doing it yourself, you'll understand what I'm talking about. Like I said, when it came to my wedding, I had a lot of greenery, and that was one reason why I decided to go with the woodland wedding theme. Woodland wedding themes would involve a lot of greenery, and greenery is much more cheap than flowers. And so that's why I decided to do that, because I was like, I can do a lot of greenery. It's going to match the theme. And then when it comes to getting extra stuff for this tables versus just flowers, there's other things I could get, like moss, and moss is inexpensive as well. So that's a big reason why I ended up going the route of the woodland wedding. If you're not doing a woodland wedding, I feel like greenery still works. You just got to get the type of greenery that's going to work for your wedding. The two fillers and greenery that I recommend the most is Israeli ruscus and baby's breath, because like I said earlier, they're both very inexpensive. You get a lot for the price that you're paying, and they're really great to just fill in any gaps inside of your centerpieces or your bouquet. My sister's centerpieces originally didn't have baby's breath in them. At first she just had like ivy, Israeli ruscus, and some white roses, and we felt that it looked a little too empty, so we just went to the grocery store, got a bunch of baby's breath, and it just made it look so much better. So I'm a huge fan of baby's breath. I'm even a big fan of just like regular baby's breath centerpieces where nothing else is in them besides baby's breath. So I went ahead and I placed my centerpiece on top of this like Dollar Tree stand I made. If I remember, I'll link it down below. And then I started adding some eucalyptus to the bottom. Eucalyptus does droop, so that's why I started to add it to the bottom, so it kind of just drooped over the stand that I made. So I used all of these more so filler type of flowers and greenery that I got at my local grocery store to create this centerpiece that you see. When I started filming the introduction shots for my wedding video, I decided I wanted to add some white roses. For sure, you want to remove any leaves and thorns there are on roses if you're going to be using them. And then I started to add those to my centerpiece. One more thing I forgot to mention, especially when it comes to a flower that has a thicker stem like a white rose or a rose in general, you want to take some scissors and cut the bottom of the rose in an angle. This helps it absorb water better, and it also makes a point to get it inside of the floral foam a little bit easier. And you pretty much want to do that with every single flower that you're using. When it comes to the greenery, you could do that, but sometimes, you know, it's not necessary. But I loved how it looked so much more when I added the white roses. It's just so pretty. And the white roses I got at my local grocery store, again, for $9.99. The price kind of changes all the time when it comes to roses. Like, it's cheaper to get them, obviously, during Valentine's Day, because then they're like, what? Like $5.99 for a dozen of them? So that is it for how I made this centerpiece using real flowers. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope it's helpful. Hopefully it inspires you guys to try to make your own flower centerpieces. I mean, you don't even have to do them if you're the one getting married. Maybe you can have a relative do them for you, or some friends to show them how to do it. Watch some tutorials with them, and I'm sure they'll be able to figure it out. It really isn't that hard to do. You just got to make sure you're giving your centerpieces a supply source of water, and you don't do it too far in advance to the wedding. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you do, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And like I said, it's so much cheaper to do it this way than to go to an actual florist. If you want to go the florist route, though, more power to you. I'll see you guys next time. Thank you for watching. Take care. Bye.